NASA's New Horizons probe has detected strange activity on Pluto.
New Horizons has shown us vistas of Pluto that we have just never seen before. Unprecedented images, including this one. This image actually looks like a snail. You can actually see what might be a shell and a head. It's really strange, and I have to admit, it looks like it's leaving a path. So, do we see space snails on Pluto?
The image shows what looks like snails gliding across the icy plains. The discovery sends the blogosphere into a frenzy.
When this thing was found, it blew the doors wide open. The internet was blazing with conspiracy theories.
Could this unexplored world be hiding the solar system's greatest secret? Everything we know about life suggests that nothing could survive in the freezing outer reaches of the solar system. The surface temperature on Pluto is minus 400 degrees Fahrenheit. Nobody is expected to see life there.
The surface of Pluto, a horrible place for life. I would say an impossible place for life. Let's put it this way. Everything in your body would freeze in a few seconds.
The extreme conditions make it unlikely the objects in the image are living creatures. And the anatomy of snails makes it impossible for them to reach such a huge size.
You better put a skeleton in it, otherwise it's just going to collapse in an unappetizing heap.
Many planetary scientists consider a geological explanation for the snails to be more likely. One potential clue to the mystery comes from images of a vast ice sheet where the snails are found.
This flat surface area on Pluto called Sputnik Planum is host to these strange markings that we find on the surface of Pluto.
Sputnik Planum is approximately the size of the Hudson Bay. Beneath its still, frozen surface, it is churning with activity.
Many people believed it was a dead world. Nothing was changing, nothing was happening. But that's not true. Pluto is an active geological world.
Under the incredible pressures of Pluto's interior, a sea of frozen nitrogen is gradually deforming, making it behave like a thick fluid. The result? A constant churn of ice.
Think of a lava lamp with a blob slowly coming up from the bottom of the lamp. This is exactly the same thing that's happening on Pluto.
Over thousands of years, geological plates of frozen nitrogen push up to the surface of Pluto, where their edges cool and begin to crack.
These lines are none other than the edges of convection zones, where warm material has come up in the center, and then cold material, now cooling, drops down along the edges.
The convection theory explains the trails as partially frozen cracks, but it doesn't explain the movement of the giant snails across glaciers of nitrogen.
These giant snails are probably water ice.
Pluto is so cold, water freezes into rock-hard mountains of ice taller than the Alps, which cluster around the edges of the nitrogen plains. Frozen water is less dense than frozen nitrogen, so it floats above it.
Water ice is going to be rock hard and might form a large iceberg. It would sit on top of the nitrogen ice.
That's what we're seeing on the surface of Sputnik Planum. We're seeing icebergs floating in a sea of frozen nitrogen.
The snails are not living creatures, but their very existence may offer new hope for life on this inhospitable world. If the temperature below the surface is warm enough to produce glacial activity, then Pluto could potentially host new forms of life.
We think of life as being on the surface of a world. It's conceivable that if you dug a deep hole on Pluto, you might find some sort of microbial life way, way down there.
80% of the life on our planet is actually underground. There's more life down there than there is up here.
In the few brief months since it flew past Pluto, New Horizons is revealing that even 3.5 billion miles from the sun, life may find a way.
There may be life on Pluto. I mean, you can't rule that out altogether, but it's not going to be on the surface and it's not going to be big.
The Soviet Union shoots down a massive research aircraft.
This was not electronic spying. This was not photographic experimentation. This was science.
For decades, conspiracy theorists accused NASA of covering for secret military operations.
The problem with the cover story is that it's baloney, and the Russians know it.
Now, declassified documents prove that NASA was framed.
It's very unlikely that NASA's being told exactly what's going on. Even people within the U.S. government don't know about these missions.